Martyr in tonight's main event. These two men have the utmost respect for each other, as we saw last time out.
Yep, this match was demanded by Robert Martyr. He wanted to face the best, and Yehi is the best in CZW today.
Martyr looking to shake the hand of Yehi. But Yehi, he is in battle mode right now. Here we go.
And Fred is 2-0. And before the action gets too deep in this match, CZW returns January 2nd, the first event of 2022. Havre de Grace, Maryland, CZW Limelight. Check out czwrestling.com for full match details and more information on that event.
Yeah, it's going to be a huge, huge event from our home away from home there in Havre de Grace, Maryland. But right now, Robert Martyr and Yehi in the feeling out process. And I think Yehi is impressed with his opponent here tonight.
Oh, I think he will be. Robert Martyr has been tearing up the independent wrestling scene ever since the pandemic era of wrestling was kindly coming to an end. And more shows opened up. He's really built a name for himself on social media with a lot of his matches that have become available. But this is going to be his biggest test to date. And that, and Armbringer there, that's the thing. You know, as good as Martyr is, he's dealing with a man who is so proficient on the mat, has such technique, that it's going to be very difficult to keep anything really cinched in. Any chain wrestling, those links will be broken, any submissions, there's going to be a counter for it. Even the way he hits the ropes, you see it, he goes down low and deep. So he had a little something extra on that tackle.
Let's go, Rob. Yeah, yeah, having some fun in the ring now, but Robert Martyr is clearly all business right now. He knows how big this match is for him. A main event spot in Combat Zone Wrestling. Yehi going for that waist lock.
Look at Martyr, though. Able to counter. He was able to break the grip, rolls through. And now it looks like he's attempting at least to lock in a key lock. Doesn't have it fully cinched in, but he knows what joints to manipulate to get there.
And you're absolutely right. Martyr's still very young in his career. Very young, I believe only in his early 20s. And he is working like a 15-20 year veteran.
Got a half Nelson trying to spin around, but instead traps the leg up, goes, rolls through. And right back to the headlock he goes. He knows that when you control the head, you control a man's body. And that's what you got to watch out for, those chops, those strikes. He's called the Savage Weight for a reason.
Say, Rob. Nope. Oh, boy. Still says no. Come on. Stay with me here, Rob. Let's go. You good? Still here.
Let's get it,
still awake.
Come on.
Come
what
on.
You got, Rob?
Yeah. And look at Martyr. It looked like he was fading a little bit, but he realizes he's in his first Combat Zone main event.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Martyr trying to attack with those chops, but look at Yehi. Yeah, just eating them. He likes those chops. He eats them for breakfast every day. And look at him. And that's the mind games Yehi likes to play.
Lured him in. Martyr left himself open, trying to brace himself for a strike. Instead, didn't have defense going to counter anything else.
Not yet. Come on, Rob.
Yeah, Rob.
Stay with me, Rob.
And at this point, Yehi essentially, this might be the first real time he's seen Martyr. Martyr's got that name out there, but Yehi is so busy traveling the country, he doesn't always have time to scout his opponents, so he initially, in the beginning of a match, always controls the pace, a feeling out process. He wants to know exactly what he's dealing with.
It's a Martyr. Martyr reversing it. Latching on to him. Well, yeah, almost like a, I don't even know what you would call it, some sort of camel clutch.
Yeah, almost like a standing camel clutch. Backpack camel clutch, but Yehi knew how to escape. And he knows the body part he is going to dismantle now. He has chosen the body part that is not going to be, that's going to take weeks to heal for Robert Martyr.
That was just brutal. And look at Martyr. You can see a little bit of fear set in.
Yeah, he looks like a victim trying to escape a horror movie monster. But you know what? He's not backing down now. Maybe he was luring in Yehi.
Martyr again using all of his, putting all of his body weight on Yehi.
He's got a head scissors in and
he's trying to pull the arm back into like an arm bar.
Whatever he was trying, it's not working out.
Oh man. Man, when Yehi, when he grabs a limb, man, he is just absolutely vicious.
I mentioned it, he dismantles you. We've seen it so far in both of his combat zone matches. Undefeated in singles competition. If he wins tonight, he'll be only one of two men to go to 3-0 since the relaunch. Martyr, though, not afraid to deliver the chops either. And this time they were having an effect on Yehi.
Continue.
Look at that. You see it. Anytime a man tries to lock on a hold, at this point, the other one doing everything he can to fight it off.
Yeah, it's clear Robert Martyr was watching Yehi footage over the last month.
No, Rob. Definitely got to study a pro at this level. What is Martyr trying to point out the tights? What's going on there?
Martyr's trying to lock his hands together. Trying to prevent Yehi from grabbing a hold of that limb and stretch it out. Martyr's trying to fight his way out of it. Interesting way to fight his way out of it. Into almost into a clover leaf. Reversing it now. Pinning combination. One, two, and only a two count.
He was trying to get Yehi to play defense on a bunch of different moves, and he went in a different direction with everything. Maybe the best strategy for Martyr is to catch Yehi by surprise. So no matter how you get the win, you get the win. I mean, there are certain rules you don't break, but outsmarting a man's one of the ones that's straight up victory. And if you can outsmart a man with the experience of Yehi, you have earned yourself that win.
Chopping him down to the mat.
He's like a lumberjack who doesn't need an axe. He just cuts through you.
Yehi starting to pick up the pace a little bit here. Going for a cover. Martyr quickly getting out of that cover.
Not even a one count. Martyr's letting Yehi know it's like he's not even close to being put down yet. You're not close to finishing him off. Well, maybe he's getting closer now.
Yeah, Yehi, though, he's picking up the pace. Those shots, those moves are getting more vicious and more brutal with each passing moment.
Hey, you gotta get on that hair. Let's go.
All Oh man, wrenching on the neck. But look at Martyr, knowing what's at stake, knowing he may have been in trouble. Finally floors Yehi with a chop.
Yeah, quickly getting a cover, but only getting a one count. And Martyr smartly staying on the attack.
It almost looked like he was smothering him at first. Really grinding on the bridge of the nose, yep.
Yehi now. Oh, what a slam! And there he is stomping at that shoulder and that pectoral muscle.
The shoulder, the pec, the chest.
Good.
All targets from Yehi, who maintained wrist control throughout all that. He's got that extra snap with everything he does. Well, speaking about snapping, here comes Martyr.
And Martyr trying to fire back, but I don't know. I think Yehi got the best of him. Martyr, his tank seems to be running low, or maybe not.
Jesus. That was a kill shot. And Fred Yehi, he knows that whatever fight Martyr has left in him might be gone, or at least is dwindling.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Fred Yehi just holding on to those, holding on to that cover, but Martyr somehow not allowing Yehi to put him down for three.
Yeah, he wanted Martyr to expend what little energy he has left on those pinfall attempts, kicking out.
Is that all you got, Fred?
Uh-oh, Martyr. Martyr talking some trash. That might not have been smart, as Yehi now is lighting him up in the corner here.
Well, when you talk trash,
there's knees.
When you talk trash, sometimes you're going to end up feeling like garbage. And that's what Martyr's got to feel like now after that.
Just a savage assault from Fred Yehi.
Martyr's got all the potential in the world, but I don't know if you should be, you know, spewing that kind of stuff against a man who's proven himself all across the country. Who major promoters have competed for trying to get him. Some of the top promoters in the world have tried to get him into their company, because that's what Fred Yehi brings.
Come on, guys, out of the corner.
Yeah, I know. Looks like he's going for a suplex here. Martyr again locking his arms around the ropes.
Yeah, looks like he's attempting a doctor bomb. Martyr knows he would be in deep trouble if he connected with that, but, you know, he might not be any safer in this.
No, absolutely not. Just peeling back those abdominal muscles, those leg muscles, that shoulder muscles. Yehi just stretching the holy hell out of Robert Martyr.
Yehi is the type of guy that when you go into battle with him, you feel the effects of the match for weeks and weeks afterwards. Before you step in the ring with Yehi, you might want to take a week off just for training. Because his cardio can go, but look at Martyr firing back now. Oh, gets cut off quickly.
Yehi now. In control. He's got, well, maybe not. Martyr firing back with that clothesline, dropping Yehi to the mat. And this might be the opening Robert Martyr's been looking for all night.
It might be his final shot. It might be his last chance to try and win this match. Once again, going back to that waist lock, we've seen the way Yehi can counter this. But is Martyr going to be able to do the same? Once again, going after the arm. And there's that arm that's been attacked several times in this matchup, but Enziguri connects, rocks Yehi.
Into a German suplex here. Off the ropes goes Robert Martyr, driving that elbow right into the temple. Martyr going for the cover here. One, two, and only only a two count as Yehi getting that shoulder up before three. What a main event we have here tonight.
Both men have let it all hang out here. Fred Yehi, Robert Martyr. Two men with something to prove tonight. Two men on a mission.
Whoa!
Exploder suplex. What's he going to follow up with? Inside cradle.
Martyr. Oh, only a two count.
We saw it was a strategy he used earlier in the match, trying to catch Yehi by surprise to get the victory, and that time it almost paid off for him.
And look at these two men. This crowd, I don't think they're cheering for any one in particular. Both these men are pulling out all the stops tonight in tonight's main event.
The look in their eyes says it all. Oh my God, goozled them.
Martyr now hitting him with those forearm shots. Looking for a trying to waist lock here. Oh, restraining him here now. Looks like Martyr's going for an abdominal stretch of his own. Yehi trying to fight out of it. Oh, wait a second. He gets that leg over.
Trying the octopus hold here. Look at the weight. Yehi knows how to block the leg, knows the counter. There it is, octopus. Manipulating the joints of the fingers, too.
But look at the strength. The strength on display from Yehi, walking himself over to the ropes to force the break.
And look, the fans know they're witnessing something special here, but is it going to be a special night for Robert Martyr?
Oh, whoa, lights him up.
Oh no, inside cradle. Yehi holds on. We've seen him use the fisherman's before.
Yehi now. It's got Martyr in that sleeper hole. This could be it.
Yeah, rear naked choke now. He has the body scissored. Cuts off the flow of blood to your brain here. Robert Martyr trying to feed off the energy of the fans. Trying to will himself to get the biggest victory of his short career. Nice counter.
Martyr now picking up the pace, driving those elbows into the pecs of Fred Yehi. Muscling him back down to the mat. Looks like he's going for a cross face now.
Set out. Looks like he's going for Rings of Saturn. A double arm bar. And look at the way he's just striking down with those anvils.
And Martyr just putting all his weight behind those elbow shots.
Koji clutch. And look at that single leg, though. He was able to counter. Now he's going to hit him with it. The fisherman's he's going for, but look at. Oh, he trapped the leg.
Whoa! And that is it. Fred Yehi, 3-0 since the Renaissance. That was probably.